save for Ryan Maxwell's feet. Banged on the inside under Paul Tannehill. Delta Work was never too far away from him. He's just behind him there under Jack Kennedy. And Manila Indo will get him in the land on my island. He's right in front of him on the edge of Blackmore. They're the first three home.
You
keep watching Ian Max's eight, and you see on the white cap and the green towards the inside, he shimmies to his left quite a bit. But what was great to watch, Ollie, from the point of view of the race, was the space that all the riders gave each other. They created room. You're running in a straight line from the start all the way to Beatrice Brook, and there was no huddle like we had last year. It's 10 out of 10 to everyone on the road in this race. It's their responsibility too, and they spanned out and used as much of the track as they could.
Sailing for the leading fancies, barring Corrin Rambler, of course. But a few horses struggling out the back.
Yeah, Statler and Aya and Mr. Incredible are dropping to the very back of the shot. Statler doesn't get much further. Mr. Incredible, he gets all the way to the chair, but he was struggling with a bit to there. This is Beecher's coming up.
And next up, Beecher's Brook. What are the riders thinking about with regards to this fence?
Not as much as they used to, because obviously it's been modified, but still as Beecher's Brook, it's a six fence. You turn them when you land. There is still a little bit of a drop, not too much, but they all took it in their stride, didn't it?
Foynaven, next up, the famous fence that saw a lot of fallers and unseats a few years ago. It meant the 100-1 winner Foynaven was able to land the prize, but no incidents here.
No incidents here. Again, Ian Max was on the inside. When he lands, he shimmies off to his left. He's in an ideal position for Paul Townend, and he must have had a dream round. A canal turn, Delta Work in the blue cap, and Limerick Lace, who's back here at the bottom of the shot with the green cap. Delta Work in the blue gets squeezed in, and Limerick Lace coming from behind ends up running into the back of a cul-de-sac and gets wiped out as well. And that was the end of Horsens.
Given the nature of the fence, it's no surprise that they get a bit congested and a few horses are bumping into each other.
Yeah, it is. Everyone's coming right to left.